I thought it was recording. And it wasn't. I'm just gonna leave it right here. I don't even care. I'm not gonna be on it too much longer. I just have to say what I have to say. I am tired, y'all. I am really tired of putting out content on this channel and watching these, I'm just gonna call them subliminal bullies. That's what they are, from the highest of the high to the lowest of the low. And I've just been putting out things on YouTube and on other sites just to see and flush them out. And I'm just gonna list them, the subliminal bullies that I've encountered on YouTube that won't let me be great. And the first one says she won't say my name. I ain't saying hers, but she knows that I'm talking to her. And she stays so booked and busy, but she always has to make a response to just let me know how rich she really is. And if all I can say is, if that comes with being rich, I never want to be in that echelon. Because if I was rich, I wouldn't care what people are doing in this sector. I wouldn't have time. I don't know. It just must be a mindset. I would not want to watch people dismantle my life on the daily, out of hatred, jealousy, or indifference. And the other one is just flying off her coattails. She's just mad because she's doing the same thing, but that's what it is. YouTube picks who it wants to go viral. You just don't go viral like that. It's like, I think it's really something that you're doing. It could be like something and people just flock to it. I don't know, but I don't think it just comes like that. And when it does, you better hold on it and ride it till the wheels fall off. That's all I can tell you, but I didn't come to YouTube for that. I came to YouTube for creativity. And I guess people think I'm a fool for coming to this channel, and I know I have great content. No, because it's real, and it's authentic, and it's original, and it's organic. Yeah, there's a word for you. But, as I call them, these subliminal bullies do everything and anything to stay in good graces because they just want a crumb to fall in their lap. And one person is so enthralled in it that I'm waiting for her to catch her a bus, a flight, or anything smoking to Milwaukee. And it ain't that damn serious. It really isn't. And I just feel like I'm just giving them content. And they're using my content because they're content deficient. And I'm not going to talk about this anymore. So I've already moved to another platform. I've already uploaded videos, and I'm just seeing one of them has been infiltrated, so I probably won't be using that one. But I do have another one that's up and working, and I've started to put content on there. I haven't decided really what I want it to be about. I have zero subscribers on that. And the other one, I don't have any followers, so you can pretty much make out which one I'm talking about. But I just want y'all to know that I will not be uploading any more content to any of my three channels because it's just being stolen and used, right down to catchphrases. And they let me know who they are by saying stuff that only I say. And I put the bait out there, and they took the hook, line, and sinker. So I see what I'm up against, and it's not really like one person. It's a whole bunch of people. And I'm just gonna say your names. I know you'll never say mine, including you, Truth Hurts. Thank you for watching my channel. I didn't even think you cared, girl, but thank you. I really appreciate that you watch my content and it inspired you to do what you're doing. The next person is Melissa B. Yes, I know you watch my channel. And see, one thing happens when you watch people's channels, you slip up and you say catchphrases that only they say or only they type on another site, and you use it inadvertently, and you can't take it back because you already spilt it out. And the discernment that God gave me, I don't watch your videos on the daily, but every so often it'll pop up on my feed and God will say, watch it. And I see things that you have done that you took off my channel. So thank you, Melissa B. Thank you, Cindy B. Thank you, Sin City, Big Red. Thank you, too, for watching my channel. Thank you, Friend Zone, for watching my channel. Thank you, Natural Chat, for watching my channel. Thank you, Free Spirit CC, for watching my channel and doing something and getting up and getting on a treadmill. At least you're trying to get yourself together. So if I can't say anything, I can say that I got you on that treadmill. I got you to change your diet and come out the box a little bit, even if you are only hating. Thank you, Wanda Willie, for watching my channel. Yeah, I know you watch my channel too. I never forget when you named one of your videos, Talk About It Tuesday, and I came in your live and you ended it. But I guess you've grown bolder because you say stuff now and you just don't care, like you want me to say something. So I'm going to address you. Thank you, Wanda Woodley, for watching my channel. And thank you, Charlotte, for secretly being a fan. I love you, girl. Hang in there. It's going to be okay. And who else? Oh, Yummy Bites. Thank you, Yummy Bites, for watching my channel. I know you're a fan. But you know who my biggest fan is? Adrian. I know you're a fan, girl. I know you like my content. There's a little inner happy homemaker in you that's just dying to get out, but you don't you don't know how to. Like those those salmon croquettes that you made. Yeah, I watched your video. Yeah. One more again. You like that, don't you? You can have it. It's for the free. Nod to Local Libra. Thank you, Local Libra, for watching my channel. I know you're a secret fan too. Yeah. I watch you too every once in a while. And I just want to give all you ladies a special thanks for watching my channel, because you've inadvertently let it slip that you watch my channel. But you never thought, like, I don't know who gave all of you the orders. And I remember coining this phrase on a website when it was hot and it was popping. And I said, if you don't give a fire oxygen, it can't breathe. And I remember saying, I can drop a match on the YouTube street and set it on fire anytime I want to. And I do. I start off on that site and I'll take a little twig and some dryer lint and let it smolder for a little bit. And then I'll just walk away. And if I don't talk, it'll die out. But if I do talk, ooh, what a flame, what a flame. I don't do it anymore because I used to be angry. I pretty much go on there now just to stay in the know, because I don't have time to watch all these different content creators. But it's kind of dried up. They'll come in there every once in a while. and it'll get cracking for a good hot minute, and then it'll die back out. That's why I know that all of y'all have infiltrated the threads, because all the old heads really won't say anything too much unless their nerves get hit, or you know what I mean, something gets on their nerves and they have to comment about it. And it's usually something that that top one did that thinks she's on top. Well, she is on top. After growing top, she bought her bag and getting her money, but everything is not about money, especially with me. And everything is not about an overflowing bag. Sometimes you just want to be able to wake up and breathe and walk and talk, even sing. And those are the things that matter to me. My bodily functions, being able to see, being able to see God's beauty, His grace and His mercy come to fruition every time He opens my eyes. Every morning that I'm given another chance to make it right. Those are the things that are priceless to me. It's not about a bag, and I don't want to have to do what you're doing. I commend you for your hustler mentality, but I don't want to be a hustler, because I associate hustling with deception. That's just me and my interpretation of what the word hustler means. I like words like entrepreneur, go-getter, a philanthropist. I like words like that. I would like a position where my money works silently while I get to live and travel and taste the goodness that God has provided for us if we honor and serve Him. That's what I want my money to do. I want it to be quiet. I don't want it to be loud and boisterous, because that's how the rich stay rich, because they don't flaunt it. They're not loud with it. They're quiet with it. And that's the difference between old money and new money. Message. Like I told y'all, I'm not going to be posting on any of my channels. What is it? Black's Little Sip of Mississippi, because I see that God blessed me with that truck. And some people feel a certain kind of way every time I get in that truck, or every time I go near the water. They do whatever they have to do, any means necessary, to try to top the video or be outside too. And I never thought it was a pissing contest. So if it irks you, oh, thank you, Cindy B, for being a quiet fan and a subliminal bully. You can't keep spreading curses out here and think that people are going to put something on your wish list or buy something on your Amazon wish list. Did your mama tell you that? That you get more flies with sugar than vinegar? Girl, please stop. So, I'm just letting you know, it's a public service announcement. I'm not going to private my videos, but I just won't be uploading on them anymore. I mean, I have 331 subscribers on my Black's Little Sip of Mississippi. I have, I think, 484 on my Black's Little Cooking channel. And I think I have 241 on my Black's Little Journey. Oh, thank you, Soulful Tea and Soulful Tea's little sister, New Life Journey. Thank you for being a fan. I see you. It's a couple of other people, but I'm not going out them because they are celebrities, but I see you and thank you for being fans. I really wish you would shout me out if just one of you would just make a comment on my page, I know it would blow my channel up. But I know you don't want me to breathe either. So, it's okay. Just knowing that you watch my channel is enough for me. But it would have been nice. But, que sera, sera. I'm moving on to greener pastures. And the way things are in Milwaukee, I'd rather just private my life because I see that I have a secret stalker. And she's trying to find me by any means necessary. And she already saw me and didn't say nothing. So I don't know what the deal is with her. Why she feels like I need to know where she is too. I know where you live. I know where you live right now. I know where your uncle lives. My auntie lives right across the street. You are so dense, girl. You're a detriment to your own well-being. I know where your mother lives. I know where Raynette lives. I know where Nico lives. And it's all because of you. And right now, I know where you are by that train track. Yeah. You always tell on yourself, do you want people to find you? Do you want people to stop you? And then you get on your channel and say that you're being gang stalked and watched and followed. Where does it end with you, girl? Seek help. Drink water. But it's taking its course. I'm not going to delete any of the videos. YouTube has this new thing, like, I don't know. They say that if your channel has not been, like, accessed, after 2 years, they're going to start deleting people's channels. So, I don't know what's going to happen to your big channel, because if you don't have access to that channel, but I don't believe that. I believe that somebody has access to their channel, and I'm going to tell you why. I made a video. And I'm not going to tell you what video, but just peak game. Yeah. Peak game. I said something about a video on that channel. And I went back to the video. And it's been edited. So, I don't know what's going on with your channel. I don't know if it has commercials. But somebody has access to that channel because if it's following YouTube guidelines and that channel has not been accessed in 2 years, it should be deleted, but it's not. It's still up and running. I don't know, because maybe it's still getting views. I don't know. But it is what it is. However it got taken, I don't know. But something strange going on with that channel that's not being said. And people are being deceptive. So. Anyhow, it's Friday. It is my Sabbath. I'm going to put one more fish fry video for the road for old time's sake. Because I won't be loading any more content on there either. I know how Lil Wayne feels when somebody you get dissed and you get walked over or looked over, it hurts. And something happened in my life that was truly traumatic. And I cannot believe that all of my so-called subscribers, nobody offered anything. That let me know that everybody that subscribed to my channel is not really a fan. They like watching my channel, but they don't want me to breathe. They don't want me to get to 500. They don't want me to be monetized, which is not a problem, because that's not what I came on here for. I came on here for creativity. But I see that a lot of my subscribers don't have my best interest at heart. I'll just put it like that. And I'm at the 15-second mark. This is going to be my last video for Black's Little Journey. It's been real, y'all. I love you. Three, six.